evening, football fans, and welcome to Calgary, Alberta, where tonight we will be reminded that in the Canadian Premier League, as in life, there are three certainties: death, taxes, and appointment viewing when Cavalry and Forge go head-to-head. Cavalry makes three changes today and a slight tweak in their formation in a 3-4-3 today, with a first start for the Cavs for Willy Accio on the right wing. Bobby Smyrniotis makes three changes to that team. Tristan Borges is in for the injured Kwesi Poku. Rubens Pasillas is in as David Chouinard is left out of the team today, and Noah Jensen will start on the bench with Abubakar Sissoko, who scored the match-winning goal in midfield. James has to be smart, but he goes and goal. Henry has to make an acrobatic stop on his own center back. That is the exact kind of headache that Cote Antigny can cause.
Antigny just saw his pace there, how quick he is. I don't think for a moment now that
a mistake. It's turned over for Sergio Camargo. Bounces off James. Accio across, and Henry again gets down in time. Casillas, ever the dangerous striker and now winger in 23. Rama, lovely clipping tackle. Tommy Carroll gets caught up with Shamik Shoaib, whose desperation defensive action helps to deny a goal. Campbell from Borges. Becker, great feed for Sissoko. Settles it down, drives it in. And now you have two Cavalry players down, following up Sissoko over the bar. Trafford tries to get stuck in with a Jabberpool. The pocket of space goes out on the left. Borges. Campbell and Pasillas in the box. Borges taking a shot. Bumps a goal. Doesn't come up empty-handed by very much. It's one where if he's on the right wing, that's probably on frame. Shinyoni Janssen. Nice job of receiving from Borges. Sissoko now. Abubakar Sissoko. Put it in, swingers. The red shirts break. Moosey goes back post. There's Trafford. Hands it down. Loose in front of goal. Fire is into me. Can't make clean contact. Forge able to clear. Moosey left foot option. And it goes short. That's clever. Now in Tigney from Camargo. Matchup by the scruff of its neck. Great service for two men with a Belgian connection. Borges in the box, Sissoko skies it. Charlie Trafford steals the ball. Floats it to Camargo. Mason goes bombing into the box. Camargo delays. Picks Trafford back out. Charlie Trafford! Kane tries to go dancing around. Charlie Trafford stays with the play. Good passing from Trafford. And he picks out the fastest man on the park. Cote Antigny is down at home and scored tonight. He goes to the middle, still dragging it on his right foot. Contact atop the box. Ben Hoskins asks the assistant referee, who says it's in the box. And Antigny has won a penalty. Referee knew that was a foul. And that's good communication with his AR on the near side. Where was the contact? They say penalty. Let's have a look, Jim. Tristan Henry 0 for 2. 2B made the stop on Mobile Bully earlier in the year. And it's actually Fraser Ayer with a long run up. And Henry denies him with a brilliant stop. But did he leave his line early? Referee blows the whistle, points to the spot. And Tristan Henry ruled to have cheated. his line, and they'll do it again. So Aaron's going to get to go again. He tried to go right down Broadway. Generally, he's low and to the right. Let's see if he mixes it up. His last five have all been there, and they've all been goals. Frazier Aaron for a third for Cavalry. And he slots it by Tristan Henry. The Cavs, 33, makes it three. And it will be 3 points for Cavalry, who are going to go to the top of the CPL table again with a convincing win over their arch rivals.
You see, every time he was getting the ball, he's just expressing himself.
Taron Campbell is stuck, trying to get a consolation by taking over the Golden Boot lead. Rising through the air is Kadeem Kane. Could not put that on target, but they are definitely poking. The Cavs have gone to the top with the Canadian Premier League title. And they absolutely dominate Forge. The most goals in a 90-minute performance they have ever scored against Bobby Smyrniotis' side. And the first time they have held a clean sheet against Forge at Echo Field. A complete team performance.